Hello and welcome to Factorio Starting Out. I'm going the wrong way. In this episode, I'm AccrettioGaming, by the way. In this episode, we will fix what we didn't fix last episode. Which way to go? Oh, not that way, apparently. Oh, and I don't. Seems that I don't have any repair packs. Let's create one to get this repaired. So, in the last episode, I made the station down here, but I didn't connect it to the turrets. So, I will do that, and I made another station as well, that I also have to do some touch-ups, should we call it that? But first, I think I should request some robots. Let's request some, where are they? Logistic robots. 20 of them should be fine. And then I have, I have the belts I need. So 20 logistic robots. I have a splitter. That's fine. Please give me the logistic robot. I don't care that much about all the other stuff. And the logistic robot is to get everything everything finished for the Sovereign station. The other station that we created is this station. And this station doesn't have any... this is basically finished. I will do some touch-ups, and I think that today I will aim to get this connected to this bit of rail, so we have all in one rail system. Let's see, what's happening? Do I get my stuff? Can I even get my stuff? Yes, I can. Okay, let's not request logistic robots. Let's just grab them. Like half a stack, that's good. Oh! Okay, let's grab half a stack of logistic robots like that. And let's grab... yeah, half a stack of construction robots as well. Then we have, then we're back to 50. And we already checked the belts and everything for the southernmost station. So we should have enough over there to be able to finish it off. Yeah, let's see. So let's put all the logistic robots in the roboport and see what is prioritized. If it is ammo or if it is repair packs. Oh no! Please don't. I don't want stuff that bad. I want you to... oh! This isn't requesting ammo, but that's actually good. I want to make sure the coal is finished before I do anything with the ammo, if it is at all possible. Because if the coal gets finished, then there is no, basically no risk at least, of the... there we go. Drop that, let's get this. And drop that over there, and this one should go this way. And then let's go to the left with these yellow belts all the way. But we basically want the fuel to be finished before we start with the ammo. If we get the fuel finished, then we can add ammo without risking any problems. If we don't add the fuel first, well, then we are risking problems. And those problems could be pretty bad, actually. It could be that we get loads of turrets that don't have any ammo. I mean, it's not worse than it is now. It would be basically the same. But I rather avoid it and make sure to get everything the right way instead. Oh yes, here we come with a bit of fuel. And the fuel goes on which side? Left side, okay. And I have loads of it over here, so let's dump all of it. And then we can get this, what, why, well, oh, didn't get all the signals placed last episode. Let's go and make sure to get that fixed. That's definitely something we want to have it fixed. Okay, that's a mistake, but it's fixed now, so no problems. Right. Oh yeah, these signals are because we have this this path. Okay, what we were about to do was to ask for some ammo. So let's ask for, there we have ammo. And our logistic robots runs to get that fixed. And then we should have the ammo situation under control. I mean, it will take quite some time before everything is fully loaded and everything is in place. But we have some turrets in the middle with ammo. And of course we have everything with fuel. Oh yeah. I need to have the yellow belts over here. If I have faster belts, these burner inserters won't be able to grab the stuff, which will make them run out of ammo, or run out of fuel, I mean, and then all kinds of problems happens. Okay, so that's that one. Let's grab that stone. And let's see, no train. And we managed to hit something. How could we go to the northwest station? Well, I think the easiest way is to go over here and then go up. So let's do that. Oh yeah, when I started this series, it was supposed to be a short series. Well, I just wanted to make sure to know how the game plays throughout the whole gameplay. Turns out it's not as easy as you think, at least not as easy as I thought it was, which is nice. I actually like that, but it's taking way more time than expected. So I might, well, I will finish this series, but might not finish it before I start with the next series. Oh yeah, and then I'm not counting the fun play, because that's for fun. That's also for learning, of course, but it's mostly for fun. Let's get rid of some stuff that's in the way for this. Railway track. Okay. That tree as well, I guess. Let's just go straight with this. Oh yeah, we don't want to. Actually, let's put that in the blueprint book. Don't know why it wasn't in the book already. Strange. Really nice ideas the computer gets. It's not what I want, but it's nice. Okay, if I miss something, it's not the end of the world. Let's have a look. Yeah, we want to go further down. So let's go through the next forest as well. Something like that. Why didn't... Oh, is it because I was hovering over the menu? I think it was. Oh yeah, let's make sure that all the robots catch up. Now we are going into an interesting section. And this section, actually I did a mistake. Up here, I should have taken the left track since that's the hardest to get past this crossing, but I didn't do that, so yeah. But I think I have to go down to this and then make sure to get left track position. Okay, there we go. I don't know if anything is in the right location. This is basically where we want everything placed. Oh, let's go for the inner track again. And let's get rid of all the power poles and all the signals and stuff. We need to go back and fix that. Yeah, there we go. Whoa. Oh, this actually works out pretty well. Don't need to worry about the trains getting into trouble. Oh, by the way, today will be pretty short episode. I don't have that much time to record today. But I hope it's enough. If it's not, well, too bad. I can't do anything about it, I'm sorry. Oh, no more power poles. Let's see if we can create some more big electric power poles. Yeah, we can. But probably not enough. Let's create all that we can. Okay, and then we want the railway to go there, so let's, oh, wrong way, there we go. This doesn't line up. If I absolutely want it to line up, what do I have to do? What if I place it one to the left, then that will come. Then this will come one to the left, which means this one to the right. Then one down. Yes, so let's go one to the left, if it is possible. Can we do that? No, we can't. So what does it mean if we want to go to the right instead? Oh, we don't have any rails. Whoops. If we want to go to the right... Well, it means a couple of steps. I don't know. Okay, let's plank down one more of these. There we go. If we go to the right, it's like going one step down. So 1, 2, 3, 4 steps to the right. Should be. It should be like that, I think. Let's hope. Let's do it like this. That, just because we can. Oh, but if we do that, then it won't, but it didn't line up anyway. Down here. So let's have a look. If we go, oh, this one, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that works, I think. Let's go there. Nah. Nope, that's a bad idea. We are messing everything up over here. Let's get rid of... yeah, all of this, actually. And everything... over here, including that, but not these, because these lines up. We do want to use those. Okay, if we do it 4 steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, then it doesn't line up with the power poles, but it's not too bad actually. Let's see what happens. This is the proper placement for the power poles. One, two, three, four. Actually, let's do it like this. Of course, let's get rid of that. Oh, let's not stand on the rail. Haven't I learned anything? There we go. And then we go to this one. We continue upwards and hopefully it will be good upwards. Why are the... oh, because those are robots from this system. It doesn't have a chest to doesn't have a chest to get rid of the rails. I need to fix that. That's one problem with my setup. I don't have a storage chest. Oh, and it seems that I don't have any more rails either. And this lines up perfectly now. Where did we leave the car? Let's have a look. I think we left it on top of this. Yeah, over there. So let's plunk everything down as we go upwards. Which isn't too bad since we basically don't have too much to plunk down. Only the power stuff. Oh, not there. Over there. And let's request some more rails while we remember it. And some more signals, I guess. There we go. And some power poles. Where are they? There they are. There we go. And let's get rid of all the trees behind these to make sure that we can plunk everything down and we have a free space basically. And we start plunking things down again. Of course it will connect all the ways here anyway, so it's not a big deal. There we go. this and this. Oh, do we have lights? No, we don't. Let's ask for a couple of extra lights as well. Oh, few more trees. It's so dark that it's hard to see when I've missed to remove something. Or maybe it's just that I am bad at looking, I don't know. But it is something at least, I know that for a fact. Let's just go past this entrance to the system, and then we have everything set up. 44 should get all 50, 9 and 50. Yeah, that's good. Get all of them, yay! Now let's go and get some extra stuff. And I think we're inside the logistics range now. Yes, we are. And the robots should get crazy right about now. Need to look at the station down here. Oh, I want the auto logistics range again. That's not good. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Now I know how to handle that. Those extra stuff we might have. Or might not. Let's see, I need some chests. Do we have automatic construction of the special chests set up? Yes, we do. Great. Let's go down and grab a few of them. We need a few passive provider chests. That's more than enough. And we need... Oh, storage chests, I mean. And we need... What... These are active provider chests. We need a few of those as well. There we go. Let's see that we stay in logistics range and then go over to the train station. Actually, let these robots get to me. Okay, that's fine. Now you can handle it best you can. Have a look. Yes, we have logistics. Oh yeah, we have other stations over here, so loads of logistics range. Let's plunk down active provider chests. And then insert those. And of course some power. And the idea is that in the outposts on the second train or second wagon, we plunk down a storage chest that can unload into the train, and then when it gets here, it unloads all the things. Everything gets unloaded from the train and gets put in the logistics system. Well, loads of stuff getting grabbed, and now all of a sudden I'm requesting them to grab things away or to remove things as well, which will of course take some time, but I definitely need the rails, It's a good thing I am questing it. Oh yeah. Oh, I'm in logistics range again. Where's the car? The car is further north. Okay, let's go over here, getting this tail to unload, and then let's go. Oh, how far out can I go? Not much further. But we need to get up to the north train station, because there is a problem that I didn't think about when building it. And it is that it's only receiving trains from one way. It's only receiving trains. Let's see, how far is the logistics? Not far enough. Well, it is possible to see what's happening while staying in logistics range. When train get into the system, they can only get from the north. But that will create problems, so I need to connect it to the south as well. And I can do that like this. Let's see. I can just do it like that, and of course fix the signals. But then I risk having trains waiting for each other. So I have to do something else, or I will do something else at least. Let's have a look, which is to have a duplicate line over here. Connecting up to this line. And this one is the line that goes... Oh. What is happening? It's too dark to see. Now let's go outside the logistics range. Oh, there's a tree trunk in the way. There we go. And there we go. So doing it this way instead. And then getting rid of these rails. We'll make sure that we have two paths to get into the system. Now I just need to get signals correct. So signal, okay, we can't do anything about that. This signal, or can we? What if I plunk down a signal down? No. Can't do anything about that. Well, maybe we can. Let's see when we get close to the end. Actually, we should start from the right. Because this one, this signal, will allow things from below. But if we go above... Yeah, it still works. There, I think. Yes. Okay, I don't think we can get this to work the way we want. But it's kind of okay. This one, 1, 2, 3. Clanking a signal down there. That's okay. We can't get an extra train to fit in this track. Well, we kind of can if we move this signal forwards. Should we do that? I think we should. Let's move this signal over there. Let's get rid of this signal. The signal should be around here, I guess. There. Perfect. Another signal. Oh, there. Yeah, that's fine. Let's get rid of this one. And another signal as soon as possible. And we have three wagons over here as well. Yeah, this kind of works. The only thing we want to make sure is that train shouldn't go from here unless this signal is free. So this should be changed to a chain signal. And then we need the input to be better than it is. Downwards. This one. That one. Yeah, that's fine. We don't need anything special. This one. Actually, this one. No, this one should only let the train pass if the next signal is fine. And we don't risk anything stopping over here and being in the way of this one. This one should be fine going forwards. But how about going to the right? Oh yeah, we need a signal over here. And it should be a chain signal. So if this isn't green, we should stop the train here, allowing trains to pass downwards. If this is green, they should be able to go all the way in here. Great. That's what we needed with the signals over here. Let's get the car. If I can find it. Oh yeah, I discovered two more errors I did. One is to have signals over here. That means that a train can go and when one train is standing still, another train can park behind it. I don't want that. So let's get rid of these signals. All the way, of course. So when this is occupied, this will... Actually, let's take one of the middle ones. When this is occupied, this one will turn red. So no trains will even get up here. And this one will turn red as well. So the train going here won't stop, won't pass that point. Instead, it might go to this station or go on to a station further down the road. Another thing we should do... Oh, I get more stuff. No, I get rid of stuff. That's even better. Another thing we should do is to place signals... Come on. Over here. But then we don't have enough power. It would be good to place signals here. That would mean that when the train starts to leave, when the first wagon have passed, then we get green signals, so the next train could start going towards this, but we can't do that. We need the power more than we need the signal, but we could get a signal over here instead. Yes, it's a minor thing, I know, but it's way better than nothing. Oh, and we should actually have signals going out as well. There we go. Otherwise, all the trains will be standing still until all of this line is empty. Oh, and we should be able to go northward as well. Yeah. Okay, let's make just one exit. And if we need it in the future, we can always change it to be more than one exit. I think that's fair enough. Because we need this exit to be built as well, going northward. There we go. Okay. I think this tree is in the way. Let's hope it's only that. No, it wasn't only that. I know they did it to make it easier, but I think it's... Oh, another tree. I think it have become harder to build rails. is true that if you don't know exactly what you're doing, it's way easier now. But if you know what you're doing and you have a plan, it was way easier before. What? Oh, is it this tree? Why? Or any of these things? Come on, why don't you just turn into this track? Why do you want to go past it and then go back to it? Please. Is there something still over here? Okay, let's get rid of all of this. All of this. Then we shouldn't have anything in the way. This we want to connect, of course. This we want to connect going north. There we go. Yeah, finally. I don't know why it took that long to get this. I have no idea. Okay, this signal is wrong. Yeah, so going here, it goes downwards, or it goes upwards. And if it goes upwards, there we go. It should only go if the next signal is green, not to stop this train. And actually, this signal shouldn't be here. We should have... Should have it over here. Well, we should have it kind of... There we go. We should have it to be able to place two wagons after that signal. There we go. Then we can place another signal over there to make sure that we stop it as little as possible. Oh yeah, and we want to have signals on this rail as well, I guess. Yeah, because this is interfering with this part of it. So let's get signal over here, going downwards, and then signal over there. How far, actually not signal over there, we want this signal to be, oh, we want to signal right after this, no, we want a chain signal right after this, and we want a normal signal in front of it, a train's length. Okay, let's get... Well, this is pretty good, actually. Yeah, that was pretty good. This is good. This doesn't matter, really, if it stops a little bit. Oh. I think I've waited too long. That some things have been timing out. Never mind. Let's get these signals fixed first. We want to signal like over here, I think. Yes. Then we want signal over here. Yes. To have at least... Oh yeah, this one and this can also have two trains waiting. And then we have... Yeah, how do we do this? We have one signal over here. Actually, let's move that signal over here instead. Have it as soon or as late as possible. And over here for this train. Have it as late as possible. Move this signal. We don't need it. We we need that track. There we go. But what do we do more? We don't want to stack up trains, so I guess we need more signals. Oh, let's have signals all the way as late as possible. Well, not really as late as possible. We could have put them one forward. It's not a big deal. That way, yes, a train may block several signals. Oh, this train even can fit a whole train. Oh yeah, but next train can't get to the stop anyway. But if we do it like this, then the trains can move forward as much as possible. And then we get into trouble. Let's have a look at the car. It should be over here somewhere. There it is. Okay, let's lower that to like 200. But we don't have enough signals, I think. Never mind. Let's lower it to 30. Let's remove that. And there we go. Can we even get out of here in this general direction? Yes, we can. Let's build the rest of the rail. I'm sorry for doing this in one go. Not doing a little bit and then cutting. I just think that today it felt like this was the right way of doing it. Oh, I think I know what happened. That was old blueprints. Now we have new blueprints. It was old blueprints that have timed out, but we have new blueprints that is from the run we did earlier today. So those haven't timed out. Okay, let's get the robots and then go a bit forwards again. Oh, did we miss anything? I was concentrating on the rails and not on the signals. But it seems that everything is fine. Let's get robots again. See, we have all 50. Great. Oh yeah, let's get rid of the trees that's growing inside the rail system. It's not the ideal place for a tree. I was about to remove that anyway. Okay. Let's get rid of those trees as well. Okay, so this robots have just been moved to a charging station because they obviously run out of power. Let's get that disassembled. Then we need this new chest, which is the storage chest over there. And yes, loads of robots flying there. And then whatever we have in here, let's just load it onto the train. And when we have it on the train, it will get taken care of. Oh yeah. What's happening with the ammo and the coal? We have nothing in the chests at least. Okay. Okay, we have ammo the whole way, but not coal. That's actually kind of strange. I would think it should be the other way around. This makes me a bit worried that we don't have enough coal. But it's good that we don't have anything flashing, meaning that everything have gotten both ammo and fuel, at least on the left side. Let's have a quick look on the right side as well. Oh, here's more coal. Okay, so here's some things flashing, but the things flashing actually are missing inserters. It doesn't have anything with anything to do with coal, which actually surprises me a bit. Let's just wait to fix that. Nothing to the right. Let's wait with fixing that until we have a little bit more coal. There we go. And now let's find the correct blueprint. There we go. Then we just plunk it down and we should get that automatically. Yes. Good that we did this extra check. But now everything is loaded up with ammo. And as a matter of fact, we have some extra ammo in the chest. Coal will take a little bit more time. Oh, we have 500 ammo and only 50 coal in that train. Maybe that's a bad idea. But that's the way it's set up right now. Anyway, let's not worry about this turnaround and all that. Turnaround will almost never be used, so let's, only for this train and only right now, stop. As soon as we get this, the train onto this wall and this wall, we won't use it anymore. Then we will have this spare train to go up to these other walls as well. Maybe even do a whole lap, starting here, go over here, one or two stations over here, and then go down to this one and make unloading here as well. Where am I? There I am. In the middle of the screen, as usual. Surprise! Well, I have to admit, It's kind of good to be able to hit that every time. And with good, I don't mean good. I mean that my aiming is good. Not that I actually mean to hit it. How's the timetable for this? Oh! Every 60 seconds. Let's change that to every 200 seconds. I don't think we need to do it more often than that. Okay. Whoa. That almost killed it. Come on. Oh, but it's in logistics range for these ones. Or not logistics range, but repair range. So let's have the robots handle it, and then I don't have to. Okay. Let's jump into this train. Since we did see that we had a problem with this train, let's fix it. We have too much ammo compared to the amount of coal. Let's change this to coal. Let's change this as well to coal. I mean, we still have twice the amount of ammo, but we will use more than twice the amount of ammo, so that's no problem. Go to that station, please. Let's pass this train, this track. Okay, so what am I missing? What is it that I'm missing most of all? Okay. It is copper. And we don't have anything set up for copper yet. Okay, let's... Let's go up here. Whoa, oh yeah. That's because we have this stone stuff. I was thinking, why is it flashing? What's wrong? But nothing is wrong. It's just set up right now. Oh yeah, this setup we could tear down, but then we won't have any protection for these chests. So let's not do that. Let's just open a gap for now. So we basically need some unloading station here for the copper and for the stone. Two different stations, of course. And coal we need somewhere as well. Well, we have this area as well. Maybe copper over here and coal and stone over here. That might be an idea. Let's see, what blueprints do I have for stations? I have this basic blueprint. This is actually what I need. There's loads of room over here at least. Let's go down and we won't do this today. We will only prepare it. But let's see, where do we have belts we have over here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So basically the copper input will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we will have the, let's see, something like this. And the copper for the first row will get in here. And then all the copper ore into the... to the furnaces over there, and then out over here, and continue downwards as copper plates. Yes, I know that we don't have it yet, don't worry. They're being emptied out fast enough. But that's where we want to have the copper. Problem is that we can't really do that because we have a lake in the way. Okay, let's start from the lake. Oh, and then we want, apart from the copper, we want some stone and coal as well. Let's have a look. Where can we put it? Let's think about it above this lake. So if we do it four like that. Oh yeah, coming to think about that. It's one thing to lead the copper ore down and into the smelting, that's no problem whatsoever. But we do need a few other things as well. And how do I handle that? Let's have a look at the map. We need coal, just leading down. no problem. Shouldn't be a problem at least. Or maybe we could even have the coal coming around the right side over here or something like that. Coal isn't a big problem. Then we have the stone, and we need smelting for the stone. So maybe we should just add another smelting setup for the stone on top of the all this copper stuff. That might be an idea. And then if we need to move it or need to change it in any way, we actually have loads of room. So yeah, I think that's an idea. Okay, so that's the stone and the coal and the copper. Then we have oil. Oil. Let's have a look at this general area. Because the oil needs to go into these pipes in some way. But I think it's a better idea to have the oil station to the right somewhere. Well, we have these pumps, and then we have these pumps, and then we have these. We don't need a station for any of those. These maybe not a station. It's not until we run out of all of these that we need an oil station. So I think, seeing that we actually do have some space, even if we have to move the solar panels, I don't think we should care too much about the oil. We just need to make sure that we do have a line. We could have a line or two over here. Could have a line or two over here. So I think we have solved most of it. Let's go up and see. I think we said that we wanted to be able to have coal over here. So let's add two lines more. So these four lines are copper. The other two is stone and coal. Is that all we need? Hopefully it is. Now let's get the station going. And yes, I think this is the right way to have the station. How do we handle this patch? I don't know. Let's not worry about it. Having the station over here, would that be an idea? Let's build it and see. Do I have the... let's have a look. Do we have the splitter set up? Well, that should definitely not have a railway symbol on it. There we go. Yes, we do have it set up. Oh, what am I thinking about? I don't need to worry about that, because these will go all the way down, and we have loads of room over here. So yeah, let's do it like this. Let's just get some power for it. There we go. Please give me some underground belts. I don't know why I'm missing that. Well, I do. I'm using loads of them. Underground belts. Anything else? Well, yes. Let's move closer. Now we're in logistics range. Okay. Underground belts. Signals. Actually, let's do it another way. Let's just go over here. And then make a blueprint of this whole setup. Do I have a blueprint I can reuse? Yes, this one is fine to reuse. Please clear it. Then we have this one from here to here. Yes. Yes, please. This is a big blueprint. And belts. And underground belts. And chests. Something like that. Just to see that it's not a railway blueprint. It's something more than that. Thank you. I think I have all the underground belts I need. Oh. Thank you, robots. Oh yeah, of course, it's the underground belts. Let's get rid of this again. Since we have the better blueprint with the correct sizes of the trains and everything, let's use that blueprint instead. Whoa, this is what I thought. Let's move to get that one. Maybe I should move it up a bit. I think I should, because then if I plunk it down over here, it would be very tight to get past this station. If I move it up like here, something like that, then I could have a car and get between the station and the or between the rail lines and the, what is it called, the lake. So yeah, let's go for this. This is where we want it. Of course this will create all kinds of problems and take a long time to complete. Let's have a look at the map. Well, it's not that big. It feels way bigger than it is. Way, way bigger. Okay, let's go down to start at the southern part. Just know that we have one part finished, and then on to the next port and the next port. Still, of course, we have, oh, we can't even see where it is because we have these whatever they are called. What are they called? Rover ports. Since we have those in place, we can't see exactly where we're going. Oh, by the way, can we hook that up with one rover port? We can, as soon as if we do it in the middle. So let's do that. Let's put another one down over here. I know the lines aren't straight. I can't do much about it. Oh, we run out of belts. Let's get a few hundred more belts. Let's continue with the rest first. Belts, chests. Oh yeah! When I connected it, it is actually connected. So the robots, both the delivery robots and the construction robots, will help out in building this. Maybe I shouldn't request 300 belts then. And I don't need more than the 90. All my robots in place and nothing being built from those. Okay, let's get rid of a lot of the rails that we don't really need. train stops. Don't we have any train stops anywhere? Do I have a chest that I can check what we have somewhere? Ooh, I know what I have forgotten. Whoops. We don't have any refueling. Never mind, I need a chest to check things right now. There we go. Train stops? No, not really. Let's create a few of them. 10, that should be enough. Let's hope that we got materials for everything. I'm not sure we do. Oh, this is wrong. Let's get rid of that. Oh yeah, some train stops. But this, we have to have that at the other place as well. Let's get rid of it over there as well. Better to fix it now when we found it. There it is. Ugly as. Whoops. There we go. And this, without thinking about it, we actually got enough space to be able to drive through it. We don't have a lot of space, but we have a bit of space. Of course, we don't have space over here without crossing the tracks, but hey, apparently you can't get everything. Is this built now? Please say it is. Okay, 2 train stops more, and this is built. And then we only need the we need some more signals. There we go. Nope. We need some more signals than that. I just saw that and that, but there were a few more signals creating problems. That should be taken care of now. Okay, do we have spares of everything? And I think the answer is no, but I can't see anything missing, so it's good enough. Okay, what are we missing? Oh, we are missing the naming, of course, of these stations. Something like that, but copper ore unload. And yes, the same names everywhere at least. It might still be wrong, but it's wrong in the same way, if it is. Only one thing missing now, and that's the refueling of the locomotive. Let's get a questor chest and an inserter. Why is the inserter over there? There we go. And please request coal and request 300 of it. And then we can make this, we don't need anymore. Let's get rid of it and make a new blueprint with, I guess, this. That's enough to see what we actually, where we should place it. There we go. Oh yeah, by the way, the reason I'm using 300 coal instead of just a few pieces of coal is that I tried a few pieces of coal in my other series, well, in the Fun Play series, which isn't really a series, but never mind about that. But it created problems that the trains sometimes run out of fuel. When I increased it, well, I don't know yet. It wasn't that long ago since I increased it, so it might still be a problem, but hopefully not. But then the question is, do we have enough coal in the system? And the answer is no. We don't have any coal in the system. Whoa. Okay. So to get this to work, we need coal. We actually have coal over here and over here. We only need to build a station to unload it. And that unload... Yeah, that's needed faster than I thought. Oh, and we have some coal over here as well. Over here and over here. But we actually need the coal, and we need it now. And we have coal over here. So maybe we should just lead some of it into a chest. Let's see, how hard would it be to connect it to the system? Well, this should go over here, the next roboport. Go. Okay, that one as well. There we go. Let's do an underground belt. And we got 23 green bottles. We don't want those. Let's get rid of them right away. There we go. That's one. We could build the next one as well. There we go with this straight up. There we go. Oh yeah, this, it seems like that one have power, this one doesn't, but we didn't expect it to. Power pole, there we go, we need more power poles, and then, yeah, this is really messy. Then do something like this. Have two. Nope. Two passive provider chests. Around two passive provider chests. And then some inserters to get the coal into the system. This way we make sure that the coal goes past the production of plastics before it goes into the system. But then it really goes into the system and we have, actually we have way too much this. Oh, let's stop this. We can't have three chests of this. We can have three inserters to the same chest. Let's make sure to empty these two out. We do that easiest by using active provider chests. Let's do it like this instead. Then we get three inserts inserting into the same chest, which is way better. Because then we only have one chest full of coal, but we still have one chest of coal, but we still have the same input rate. And this will, one, two, three, yeah. There's a lot of coal going for the train stations, but this will sooner or later fill up the train stations, and then we have at least some iron train stations up and running. Oh, let's have a look. These, I don't care that much about mining drills. But I think I want to get rid of these three. 4.7. And since we have the speed modules, let's plunk them down. There, there. This one, 3.5k. Let's pick up this one. Oh, I had a few already. Plunk down another one. Just to make sure that we get it mined out a bit faster. Yeah. Robots don't have enough charging points. But that's kind of okay. This is a one-time thing. It will use loads of coal. After this is finished, it won't use loads of coal again. Just like 10 or 20 or 50 at a time. So let this take time. Doesn't matter really. Oh, and we're actually running low on coal. Let's see that our miners have... Well, we have enough that we could kickstart the steam engines. Which is one of the good things. We are mining with this, which is good. We are actually mining coal from far away. This is way further away than I thought it would be. And here we have miners working, but we have loads of coal over here. Yeah. 23, 22, 20k, 13k. We have loads of coal. We don't have to worry. 14, 17, and then we have these. Well, they, it's not big patches, apparently. But we have loads of coal, and this would give like 6k, 5 or 6k. So we have enough coal. We don't need to worry about that. And the mining rate, well, we don't worry about that either. It will catch up sooner or later. And when it does, it's good. Should we worry about fast transport belts? No. Not really. Well, yes. Since we noticed, let's fix it. And it doesn't really do any difference. Since at the moment it's the miners that's the problem. And the miners won't mine faster just because we have faster transport belts. What did I do? I don't know. Please give me some belts, someone. Come on, robots. You can do it. I need belts. We're actually getting more stone into the system now. And I guess it's because the robots are busy with coal. Oh yeah. So busy that they won't even give me some belts. Damn robots. Oh well. Then I just have to grab them myself, I guess. Since we're down here anyway, let's get rid of this splitter. Something else? No. Belts? Yes, we have loads of it. I don't need to worry about grabbing a bit of it. Ooh. Let's finish this and then it's the end of the episode. Okay, I think all of that is finished now. So I have to say thank you for watching. See you next time. Whoa, wait. I really want to get rid of this stone. So why don't I put down another miner? Yeah. Okay, and some power, I guess. Okay, let's get rid of that and those two and give it to this one. Then it should be a bit faster, I guess. Well, never mind that. That was an extra thing. Anyway, thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.